pressure ratio is atmospheric pressure divided by a certain number. In this case, using these this equation, we've multiplied atmospheric pressure by 4 times. This happens to be the maximum amount typically seen on a turbo compressor map. Hey, can we show a compressor map? Do we have one we can put on? You have to understand that when boost pressure reads 0 on your gauge, it's really reading 14.7 or PSI. That's atmospheric pressure at sea level. So if higher altitude, it'll read a little lower than that. But the true pressure wherever your gauge reads is 14.7. So you're going to take that amount and add it to the boost pressure you see on your gauge. So in this case, we've got 44 PSI plus the 14.7 PSI. Then you divide that amount by the 14.7, and that's the atmospheric pressure you're dividing by to obtain a true pressure ratio. We're basically going boost pressure plus atmospheric pressure to give true pressure dividing by atmospheric pressure. That gives us a true pressure ratio. The reason we use 44 PSI in this example is because 44 PSI is a 4-to-1 pressure ratio, and that's the max pressure ratio we typically see on a compressor map. So anyone that makes over 44 PSI in a single turbo is getting beyond what we call the map range of their turbo. That means they're beginning to convert a lot of their pressure into heat during the compression process. And it doesn't matter how large your turbo is. Even a 100 millimeter turbo compressor will end at a 4-to-1 ratio. And this is just the simple law that applies to centrifugal compressor wheels. That all turbos use centrifugal compressor wheels. So what if you need more air than 44 PSI to keep your EGTs down and burn all the fuel you're injecting, and you already have a big aftermarket turbo? A simple solution, really the only solution, is going to be compound turbos, or twins as we call them. The reason why is the laws of physics are on your side with compound turbos. If we take this example of a truck making 67 PSI, it's got a set of our twins on making 67 PSI. If we run the pressure ratio overall, we're gonna get 5.6-to-1 pressure ratio, which is really high. Cool thing about this is at this extremely high boost pressure ratio and high boost levels, each turbo is only running at about a 2.36-to-1 ratio. Now, right here, is where we're going to destroy some of those myths we hear about on compounds or turbo kits. We read about them on the forums, and we have customers call us all the time and ask us these questions. So many people think that you have to split the boost pressure on each turbo. That's simply not true. We read on the forums, and a lot of customers call in and say, I want my low pressure turbo to run at 30 PSI. I want my overall at 60 PSI, so it's split evenly. So I'm gonna show you here that's not what you want to do. You've got to understand that pressure ratio is everything in a turbocharger, because that's how the turbo deals with atmospheric pressure and the speed of the turbo and the efficiency overall. In this example of the overall pressure ratio at 67 PSI on each turbo, or each turbo is running at 2.36-to-1 ratio, which is a very efficient speed. On compressor maps, turbos are the most efficient between about 1.7 and 2.6-to-1 ratio. And because our turbos here are each at a 2.36-to-1 ratio, they are very well within the most efficient point that turbo will compress air. The low pressure turbo in this case is only making 20 PSI of boost, so it's not spinning dangerously fast. Therefore, it will last longer as well. We have a lot of people call and say, I just want something that will last forever, that won't go out, and will be really reliable. And a single turbo running at 44 PSI is going to go out a lot quicker than a turbo that's running, than the compound kit that's running at 65 PSI. If you put that compound, or a single turbo run at 44 PSI and compound it, you're typically going to see it's spinning considerably slower at a lot higher boost in compounds. And so the turbos are gonna last longer in compounds than they would as a single. The results are very cool charge air going into your engine, which makes the air very dense. With more air molecules to help burn fuel, you're going to not only have the air molecules enough to burn the fuel, but you're going to have extra air molecules to help carry the heat out. This is another extremely cool feature of our compound kits. They not only produce enough air to completely burn huge amounts of fuel in the cylinder, but there are extra air molecules that don't get consumed in combustion that actually are going to carry heat out of the cylinder. This is the exact process that jet engines use to keep their exhaust streams cool. They call it a bypass ratio, and the jet engines use that bypass ratio to carry heat out of the exhaust stream so that they don't melt the internals on their jet engine. This bypass ratio that jet engines use with the case of our twin turbos, that instead of calling it a bypass ratio, we're just simply adding so much air into the cylinder that there's enough air to consume all the fuel and the extra air to cool things internally. It's an awesome process and really significantly lowers your EGTs. There are just so many benefits with compounds. As we state on our website article that you can read on our website, we have a twins versus single turbo comparison where we kind of write the laws of physics and explain them in that article. The laws of physics don't allow a single turbo to beat a set of compounds. How does anyone argue otherwise? And your laws of physics are just on your side with a set of compounds. Now, the other thing we're going to cover a little more in depth is our compound turbo kits allow very quick spool up. And it's because they have a small turbo and a very low RPMs, and then they've got a really high overall airflow. The airflow in the compounds is typically going to be about 2.5 to 3 times that of a single turbo, so it widens the compressor map immensely, and it really becomes the holy grail of turbocharging. All these people that call up and they say, I want a ton of horsepower and I want my truck to spool like it was stock. The only way to do that, the absolute only way to do that, our compound turbos do that. And it's really exciting the way they do that. Let me quickly summarize what I've just said about our twin kits versus the single turbos. The benefits of compounds are cooler, more dense air, plenty of air to burn large amounts of fuel in your cylinder, additional air molecules to cool your cylinders. It adds horsepower because it brings the drive pressure, the exhaust drive pressure to boost pressure, very near a 1-to-1 ratio. Here's a question. Actually, not a question. Okay. Here we go. I see the benefits of compounds, but way too expensive. All right. Hey, thanks, Joe, for asking that. Yeah, compounds definitely are more expensive than a single turbo. But if you really consider what they do, the benefits are dollar for dollar best money you'll spend on your engine. Especially if you consider so many people spend useless money on products that do virtually nothing, like the air intakes, the exhaust systems. By the time you spend money on a cold air intake, single turbo, exhaust systems, and an intercooler, it would be way less expensive to have bought one of our compound kits, and it would do way more for horsepower, EGT control, performance. All the other things combined. Just don't go nickel and dime yourselves to death trying to get bits of performance to buy little components that do virtually nothing, because it will be money completely wasted. The other thing to consider is how much your engine is worth. Your engine, to rebuild an engine, is between like $5,000 and $15,000, and heat is what will destroy an engine. So the compound kits virtually never will have a heat issue on an engine like a single turbo will. And so it's going to save you a ton of money getting the compounds right up front, especially when you start adding a ton of fuel to your truck. Get the compounds in so you don't melt the motor. So now to focus on my statement of increasing the horsepower by making the drive and boost pressure more equal. Here's an example of a stock turbo running at 40 psi of pressure. It will typically have the exhaust drive pressure of 70 psi, meaning the intake manifold would have 40 psi of boost, and the exhaust pressure, or the exhaust manifold, is going to have a pressure of 70 psi. So then this is a negative 30 psi, and that's what it takes to drive the turbo on a single turbo application on a stock turbo. In other words, there's 30 psi negative pressure between the two sides, which really hurts performance. For comparison's sake, if we do one of our add-a-turbo kits, or like we call them, the stocker S475, that compound kit will make approximately 65 PSI of boost when the exhaust drive pressure is at 70 PSI. Because the boost pressure is so much closer to the drive pressure, there's a net gain in horsepower, bringing the boost pressure and drive pressure nearly to a 1-to-1 ratio, as our compound turbo kits all do. This has a huge impact on the actual horsepower. On our full compound kits, like say the 62 over an S475, that will be even at a 1-to-1 ratio or even better. So typically 60 PSI on one of our full kits will have about a 55 to 60 PSI of exhaust drive pressure. So the effect this has on the actual engine is shown here, as the exhaust stroke, the engine has to exert about 60 pounds per square inch to push the exhaust out of the engine to drive the turbo. But then during the intake stroke, our compound kits push downward on the piston by the same 60 PSI entering the cylinder. This actually results in horsepower being created on the intake stroke. So that's a really cool feature that the compound kits have. The results of adding a compound kit in this example that we've shown here increases horsepower by between like 25 to 28% on average over the stock turbo. So to quickly add one more huge benefit of the compound turbos over a single, I'm gonna show you the air temperatures and exhaust temperatures. So a single turbo at 40 PSI will build approximately 500 degrees of temperature on the air leaving the compressor before it gets to the intercooler. That means air exiting the compressor before it hits the intercooler is about 500 degrees on a single turbo at 40 PSI, whereas a compound kit running at 60 PSI is only gonna have about 370 degrees of temperature when it exits. So a lot more air, a lot higher boost at a lower temperature. So cooler, more dense air, and more of it. That's exactly what your engine likes to see. So what you'll see in your truck because of this is a huge decrease in the exhaust temps, like in the realm of like 300 to 400 degrees over a single turbo. So exhaust temps are gonna drop 300 to 400 degrees on one of our compounds over your single turbo. The last huge benefit of the compound kits versus a huge single turbo that would even somewhat compete in handling the same horsepower, I'll show here in this example a single 66 turbo that flows approximately 1250 CFM. And that turbo on a 5.9 Cummins will usually spool around like 2000 RPMs or sometimes even a little higher. In contrast, we take one of our large compound kits, our 647112 over an S480, for example. It will flow 2850 CFM and spool right around 1550 RPMs. I mean, you can see by this, there's almost no comparison. You get quicker spool up and over double the airflow from our compound kits compared to a huge single turbo. And this huge single turbo like this is about the biggest turbo you can run on a 5.9 Cummins unless you go into like one of the S400 series. And those are just crazy. Those are like sled pull only. And even those, the compound kits outflow those, the overall airflow on those. So one more quick comparison. I have here a graph that we've actually plotted off points to match real dyno points, so we could have a good comparison. Even though it's hand-drawn on the graph, it's pretty accurate. So a single stock turbo is shown right here, and it makes good bottom end power and torque, but it really chokes out at the top end, and EGTs at about a 400 horse level are really hot, as you can see. They're like 1500 to 1600 degrees, depending on your altitude and that. And that's what we're seeing at our altitude, is like 15 to 1600. We're about 4,500 feet altitude here. And let's compare that to our compound kits. At this horsepower level, we would recommend to someone probably a 62 over the S475. Now notice how the horsepower is considerably higher. This is the same fuel going in the motor, and you're gonna come up over 100 horsepower with one of these compound kits at a 400 horse level. Then EGTs are gonna drop in the realm of 400 degrees. Now if you compare that to a really big single turbo, like say that 66-74-14, and we don't even sell those turbos as a single because they spool so slow, but a lot of guys are running those, and that's why we're comparing it here. So that big of a turbo will run cooler at higher RPMs by about like 150 to 200 degrees because it's so big, And it does push, you know, a decent amount of air compared to the stock turbo, but nothing compared to our compound kit. But it's going to run really hot at low RPMs because it doesn't even spool up until about 1900 to 2000 RPMs. So look at the difference in horsepower between any one of our kits at 1800 RPMs. Because 1800 RPMs in that realm is where you're going to be driving on the freeway. At those usable, really usable RPM levels are literally going to monkey stomp those huge 66 type turbos that people are running. And I think this graph pretty much speaks for itself. So let's go to a question.